Hello and welcome. Ansys Fluent is a state-of-the-art computer program for modeling fluid flow, heat transfer, and chemical reactions in complex geometries. It comes with a single window workflow which allows users to mesh geometries, set up models, solve and post-process the results. Ansys Fluent can be started using the Ansys Fluent Launcher. In this video, we will look at the various aspects of Fluent Launcher, the various Ansys Fluent file types, and how to customize Ansys Fluent Solution Mode user interface using the Preferences panel. I have started the Fluent Launcher by typing APPS:FLU in the Type Here to Search box in the Windows taskbar and selecting Fluent 2022 R2. You can also start Fluent from the Windows Start menu. Before starting Fluent, I will briefly show you the various features of the launcher. On the left of the panel, you can choose what mode Fluent will start in. Start Fluent in meshing mode if you want to generate a new computational mesh. If you already have a numerical mesh available, you can start Fluent in solution mode. As I already have a mesh file available, for the purpose of this demonstration, I will select solution mode. Next, in the drop-down menu of the capability level option, I can select one of the available levels, Enterprise, Premium, and Pro. The choice should be made according to your license level. In terms of using Fluent, there is no difference between Enterprise and Premium. Both allow use of the full range of Fluent's models, features, and capabilities. The only differences are related to a small number of other Ansys products bundled with the CFD license. The Pro license level limits the functionalities made available to the user. In meshing mode, it allows only the use of the watertight meshing workflow, and in solution mode, it allows you to simulate only steady-state turbulent flow, including compressible flow, and heat transfer, including conjugate heat transfer. By clicking the arrow next to show more options, here on the left of the launcher, I can set the working directory. This is where Fluent will initially look for any files that you want it to read, so I always like to set that to where my files are, as I find this is very convenient. If you click on Show Learning Resources, you can see there are links to a variety of useful information and learning resources. There's links to the new release notes in the Ansys documentation, links to interesting content from the Ansys website, there's tutorials, there's links to the Learning Hub, and also instructional videos on our YouTube channels. I encourage you to spend some time getting familiar with these. They can be a useful source of information. Now, in the launcher panel, there are a variety of options available so that you don't have to bother with the working directory. If you have a file in the recent files list that you want to open, then obviously you just select that file and click Start with selected options, and it reads that file. If you want to clear the recent files list, you can just right-click and do that here. If you have already selected one file from the list and you would like to clear its selection, you can do this by clicking the Clear Selected File button. The Case Mesh File Info button, available when you select a file from the recent files list, will return a summary of useful attributes of the selected mesh or case file, including its version, precision type, dimensions 2D or 3D, and the cell and node counts. Under Get Started With, there are options to have Fluent start while simultaneously reading a mesh file, or a case file, or case and data file, or also a journal file, which I will describe a little bit later on. On the right, I can choose whether my case is two-dimensional for a two-dimensional mesh or three-dimensional for a three-dimensional mesh. If a previously used Fluent case file or mesh file is selected to be read into Fluent, this option is automatically set based on the information in the file. I can choose whether to use double precision which is recommended for most cases as it reduces round-off errors, or single precision, which uses less computational resources during simulation. In the launcher panel, I can also select parallel and set the number of solver processes to the number of the available cores, which is 4 on my computer. What parallel does is, if my computer system has multiple cores available, Fluent will divide the calculation into the number of processes entered in the panel and then solve each part simultaneously on a different core, resulting in obtaining a solution faster. For example, if there are at least 4 cores available on my computer, when I select 4 processes, the calculation will finish 4 times faster than it would on a single core. Finally, if you are starting Fluent with a mesh or case file, it is a good idea to enable Display Mesh After Reading, which will automatically display the computational mesh immediately after loading. It looks like everything is ready now, so I will just click on Start to open Fluent and get started. This is a good point to review the Fluent file types. There are 3 types, which are mesh, case, and data files with default extensions .msh.h5, .cas.h5, and .dat.h5, respectively. The file extension .h5 indicates that the file is written in the Common Fluids File Format, or CFF. CFF files have built-in compression and offer greatly improved read and write performance compared to legacy files. Files saved in older versions of Fluent use the legacy file types with the extensions .msh or .msh.gz for mesh, .cas or .cas.gz for case, and .dat or .dat.gz for data. These files can also be read in Fluent. Mesh files only include the mesh and the names of the boundary and cell zones. Case files include the mesh and also contain all the setup information that you define, such as boundary conditions, material properties, and so on. Data files contain only the solution data, so if you want to view the results, that means you must load both the case file and the data file. There is one other way that you can open a file in Fluent, and that is by dragging it from Windows Explorer into the Fluent window. I have a mesh file here, so I will just drag it over the window, and when I see the copy icon, I can drop it on the window and it loads that file. You can do this with case and data files too. A few things I would like to show regarding Fluent window customization. If you would like to change the default Fluent settings for mouse button mappings, default graphics effects, display options, and other settings, go to the File menu and select Preferences. Any changes that you will make here in this panel, for example for the appearance, dark scheme, graphics, reflections and shadows, how the mouse buttons behave, will be effective for the current and also any future Fluent sessions. Any changes you will make in the main Fluent window will only be active during a Fluent session, but will revert to the options in the preferences for future sessions. In this video, we have looked at the various aspects of Fluent Launcher, the various Ansys Fluent file types, and how to customize Ansys Fluent Solution Mode using the Preferences panel. Thank you very much for watching.